Initially, the spirits were described as lamps of burning fire. This is only natural since fire is a form of plasma. There are alternate translations of the verse, where torch is used to translate the original Greek lampos instead of lamp as the King James Version has it. Lampos can mean lamp, torch, or lantern depending upon the context. The archetype of the seven spirits fits both interpretations depending upon the stability of the plasma jet, whether it was the blazing flame of a torch or the steady flame of a lamp or candle. The plasma jets of Venus became the archetype of the lamp symbolism in scripture and throughout the world. Ancient lamps were designed after the archetypal lamp in the heavens, where the crescent shining on Saturn due to the light of the sun became the body of the lamp, and one of Venus's plasma streamers became the flame. This version of an Aladdin's lamp fits the archetype perfectly. The scriptures use this archetype to typify gospel themes. The most famous use of the imagery is the parable of the 10 virgins, where each virgin is required to be prepared for the wedding feast by trimming their lamps with oil. This same imagery gave rise to the concept of the eternal flame, which never dies. In the case of the virgins, readiness is to always have oil in their lamps, waiting for the call by the bridegroom. The Lord extended this archetype to his disciples, wherein he told them to keep their lights burning. He also declared that his disciples were the light of the world. The archetype is quite apt, since the flames emanating from Venus were always present in the heavens and were never quenched. The disciples could see the archetype as a constant reminder, since the polar configuration was still present during the lifetime of the Savior. This same archetype is used throughout the world to represent eternal flames at gravesites and war memorials. In the photograph of the eternal flame in East Berlin, the soldier standing with the torch in front of the eternal flame duplicates the symbolism of the archetype. The soldier represents the cosmic man, his body being the axis mundi. His extended arm arches like the Saturnian crescent. The torch represents one of Venus's plasma jets. The torch archetype is merely a variation of the lamp, where the plasma jet appears more unstable, characteristic of a blazing fire and not a single flame. Examples of this archetype are the torch of the Olympic flame and of Lady Liberty. In our first example, a woman is acting in the role of an ancient Greek high priestess, lighting the torch from an eternal flame. The crescent bowl holding the eternal flame is supported by a Doric column representing the axis mundi. Our second example is the Statue of Liberty, one of many versions of Lady Liberty, a representation of the female goddess. In this version of the goddess, Lady Liberty is holding a blazing torch. The second photo of the statue highlights the fact that her crown is made up of seven rays, mirroring the original seven spirits of John's Apocalypse. Torches have been used throughout the world, anciently and today, in a number of ritualistic ways. The candlestick is a natural variation of the lamp and torch archetypes. This planetary symbol is used throughout the scriptures and, indeed, in temple ritual. John himself uses the imagery in the Apocalypse. The seven spirits become the seven candlesticks. John first mentions candlesticks in his vision of the one like unto the Son of Man. The candlesticks numbered seven, which accords with the seven spirits. Each spirit was a separate flame of a separate candlestick, with the Axis Mundi providing the stick and candle for the flames. John uses the image of the seven candlesticks to symbolize the seven ancient churches. In one case, John uses the image of two candlesticks. The archetype is the same, though the number is different. The candlestick archetype was also used collectively as a seven-branched candlestick, where all seven spirits or flames are part of one candlestick. As before, the Axis Mundi is the central stick and stand, with the other spirit flames being the seven lamps of the candlestick, three on each side of the central flame. It was this seven-branched candlestick that Zechariah saw in his vision of the two anointed ones. The two anointed ones are the two witnesses of John's revelation, both to be explained in a later episode in this series. The most famous example of the archetype is the menorah, the seven-branched candlestick first designed for the tabernacle of Moses. Moses was given the design of the menorah by the Lord himself. In addition to the fact that the design of the candlestick was an exact replica of John's seven flaming spirits atop the Axis Mundi, the Lord himself indicates that he showed Moses the planetary archetype as a visual model. Like all true prophets, Moses was not only on the mount, he was shown the mount, that is, the sacred world mountain or Axis Mundi, and the archetypes he needed to see to build the tabernacle and its furnishings. One of the archetypes he saw was the heavenly seven-branched candlestick. The menorah was placed by the table in the Holy of Holies. The table and candlestick were in front of the veil, which separated them from the Ark of the Covenant, the terrestrial replica of the heavenly throne. In other words, the menorah, like the seven spirits, stood before the throne of God. And, like the ever-burning celestial archetype, the menorah was to be kept burning at all times. It was an eternal flame.